Second important thing to understand a framework or to use it effectively is to understand the database, the tables the framework uses to store its own data, so that you can get it directly if you need to. So the CMS part of the database is JOS underscore content, content front page, rating, categories and sections. So this is four tables which are used by CMS of the Joomla. So all your CMS data, every time you create an article, every time you write a blog, these are the four, five tables which stores that information. No other table has any other information about your articles. These are other Joomla, basically few tables which are used by different components, which by default come with the Joomla, like messaging, contact details, that is the address book, polls, ratings, news feeds, and links. But the real tables or the core tables for Joomla framework are these. These are template tables wherein the information about template is stored, components table wherein information about a component is stored, modules table, and menu. So these are the JOS underscore component, JOS underscore module. For templates, tables are template underscore position and template underscore menu, JOS menu. These four five tables are used for your component management. So when you're installing a component, an entry will be made in JOS underscore component, and how that component is to be, what is the link that is required for that component. For templates, item ID is required for templates. So based on item ID, template is picked. So which item ID is responsible for which component template is stored here. And last, most important thing or the most important feature that Joomla provides is the user management. And it's stored in these four tables. One is JOS underscore users. Other is JOS core underscore ACL underscore ARO graph, groups, ARO map, and group core ACL ARO. Even if you create a user in JOS underscore users and insert create a user directly, Joomla will not recognize the user. Joomla will not allow you to log in unless all these tables are also taken care of. Which means you need to understand these three tables as well if you want to use Joomla's user management system. The relation is something like this. ACL is action control list. ARO is action request object. Group is group for this AROs, and we need to have a map in between so that which group has what rights. So the system implemented here is quite fine, as in we can have a very broad level of rights to a very fine-tuned rights. But Joomla has implemented this in two ways. Half of it is in tables, half of it is in codes. So those two files that it was included earlier, JCL underscore class.php and api.php, they have half of the logic, user management logic, implemented over there, and half of them is in the database. So it makes it bit difficult to create new user types in Joomla.